Deadzone sources allows you to configure the way how the joystick Deadzone works. You're given three Deadzone types. The None type relies on the game's Deadzone input. It's selected by default as most games already have their own Deadzone settings. And Halo, the Master Chief Collection, is no exception. If the game doesn't offer that option, you may need to enable that. And for configs with keyboard mouse bindings or set the joystick output as a relative mouse, you're gonna do the same thing here. The calibration type will center the inner Deadzones based around the Steam input's universal calibration settings. For snappy sprite games, this will be enabled by default. In theory, I can just ditch the game's Deadzone settings and let the calibrate joysticks do the heavy lifting. Prior to this recording, I already calibrate my joysticks in advance. But you can head over to Steam's general control settings. You can either auto-calibrate or do it manually with the slider. It takes longer to calibrate with the standard gamepad, but the process is much faster with the Steam controller. Everything's mostly handled by the controller's firmware. If you want to create your own Deadzones, the configuration mode allows you to configure both inner and outer Deadzones. It should allow us to create Deadzone shapes. For Steam input veterans, this should be familiar to you since it's the same type of functionality we're used to. If not, I recommend watching this video by Critical Input on how joystick move input style works.